When you download something from the internet, whenever possible, you should check if the hash of the file matches the one given, to make sure that the file is not corrupted. In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can make your own hash generator. Okay, so I've already created a file called hashgenerator.py, and I've got my video.mp4, which is the file that I'm going to generate the hash of. Okay, so let's start out by importing the module we need, which is Hashlib. You can have a look at the documentation if you want to know more about that. Then I'm gonna write my path. I'm actually going to copy and paste it like that. Okay, and I'm gonna use a row string. I'm gonna use a row string because these characters with a backslash can actually be treated as escape characters, and we don't want that. We want them to be treated as literal characters, okay? So we need to use the R at the beginning. Then I'm gonna open my file, write the path, RB. So R means reading mode, and B means binary mode, because there's also a text mode. By the way, I've actually made a video about how to write to and read from text files, so go and check that out. I'm gonna leave the link in the cards up above and in the description box down below. So as opened file, and then I'm gonna read the content of that file. So open file.read. Read actually reads the whole content of the file. Hashlib actually has hash generators for each hash. So there's one for MD5, etc., etc. And I'm gonna create them. These methods create an hash object for that specific hash. So MD5. Hashlib.md5. Okay, nearly that, right? So those return hash objects, and now we're gonna update them with the update method, which actually generates the hash for us. So md5.update, and here our content. And I'm gonna copy this. So okay, so now we've updated the hash objects, and now I'm gonna print the result. So result. Print a space, then I'm gonna use a formatted string. The first is gonna be, so name here is actually the name of the hash, in this case MD5, and is an attribute of the hash object. So then hexdigest. So hexdigest returns the hash in hexadecimal digits, okay, which is actually the format that you usually find when you, for example, download something from the internet, okay, and then you want to check if the hash of the file that you've downloaded is the same as the one given by the website's owner to make sure that you have the right file, okay. So I'm gonna do that for all of them. Okay, so now everything should work. So I'm gonna save the file and let's try to run it. So Python hash generator. Let's see. And there you go. You've got all the hashes. All right. Perfect. So there's actually a better way to do that instead of having all the same code for all of those. Okay. So I'm going to comment this out. Okay. Then I'm going to copy those. And uncomment them. Okay. Then I'm gonna add them to a list. I'm gonna call it list hash objects. So okay, so we've got our list of hash objects. Then I'm going to open the file as we did above, rb, file, I'm going to print result, space, then I'm going to read the content. So it's the same. And now I'm going to loop through the list. So object in list hash objects. Okay. So it's going to do this for every object in the list. So then I'm going to update the object with the content. Perfect. I'm gonna print and here hash object and hash object. And there you go. So this is exactly the same as this, but the code is a bit shorter, okay, and cleaner. So I'm gonna save the file. Let's try that out. And there you go. So as you could see, in this case, the hashes are printed one by one because up here, we generate all the hashes and then we print them. So it takes a little bit longer to generate all of them. In here, we actually print that as soon as one hash has been generated. So you can actually see that the hashes are printed one by one. Okay, perfect. That could be a problem with this code because here you have to read the whole file. Okay, that means that in memory, if you've got a file that is, let's say 2 gigabytes, in memory, you'll have 2 gigabytes in RAM, okay? And you don't want that because if you've got small files, it's fine. But when you've got big files, it could be really memory consuming and you don't want that. So there's actually another way to do this for bigger files. I'm going to comment this out. Okay. So basically, you need to read the file line by line and update the hash object for every line, okay? So that instead of having the whole file in memory, in RAM, you've got only one line. Okay, so I'm going to loop through the list of hash objects. Then I'm gonna open the file. That. So basically we open the file for each hash object, okay, not just once, in this case 6 times, It's going to take longer, but it's so much better because we're going to use less memory, especially when you're dealing with really big files. We could actually use seek, which is a method of the file object, to actually start from the beginning of the file. So for each hash generator, we could start from the beginning and then read it, and then from the beginning and then read it. But I'm just going to keep things simple here. So I'm just going to open the file 6 times, once for each hash generator. So now I'm going to look through the file line by line like that. And then I'm going to update the content. Okay. So when you call update, you can call it just once with all the bytes of the file, or you can call it multiple times. So you've got the hash object, then you update it with one line of bytes, and then you'll update the hash object again with another line, etc., etc. So at the end of the process, you will get the same hash. Okay, so then I'm gonna print the result. I'm gonna use this code down here like that. Okay, so basically this does exactly the same, but it's so much better because it uses so much less memory. So let's save it. Let's try that out. Let's see. Looks like we're getting the same results. As you can see, it takes a little bit longer, but as I said, you don't need to worry about using too much memory. Okay. This is actually a pretty simple and little hash generator. You can use this to check if something that you've downloaded is the right one and gives you the same hash as the one that the owner actually wrote on the website. So, okay, so now I'm going to close this, this, and this.